All right, here we go. Hey, it's Fran at the Bunch. Got something new. I picked this up at the store. This is a 2021 Lite Brite, and super nostalgia trip. I had a Lite Brite back when I was like 4 or 5 years old. Absolutely loved my Lite Brite. Of course, the original ones had a really deep back, sort of, because they had a 10 watt light bulb in the back, and so they looked like a television set or a television tube. Probably another reason why I found it irresistible. But I mean, there's nothing more, you know, candy-like for total technical nerd, even a burgeoning 4-year-old tech nerd, than a set of little candy little pegs that illuminate and glow pretty watery gem-like colors. So yeah, a lot to love about the Lite Brite. But this one obviously is not sticking out in the back. You know, there's obviously no light bulb in this. This is done with an LED panel. But before I get into actually playing with this, like I'm 5 all over again, I wanna take a look at it, maybe open it up and see what they're doing to make a really diffused panel that's gonna run off of 3 1.5 volt AA batteries. Oh, and extra bonus, more colorful pegs. You want more colorful pegs, definitely. And this one says contains 214 pieces. So choose a picture, insert color glow pegs, watch them light up. I intend to. Thank you very much. All right. Ooh, okay. Got that up. Ooh, yeah. So these are. The original Lite Brite had really kind of dark, like very, very colorful pegs. These are, they're hardly colored at all. I'd imagine this is because the light source is so dim that they couldn't have like the solid, because the original Lite Brites, it was like ruby red, like emerald green, sapphire blue. This is not like that. These are not the same. Well, I'm gonna suspend my judgment on the pegs. Although, for me, the colors of the pegs were everything with the Lite Brite, the original Lite Brite. These colors don't really do anything for me. The green is barely green. So, I might have to get a, I don't know what happened to my original Lite Brite kit. I think I lost it like 5 or 6 moves ago, but I might have to get some vintage pegs if I want to get those really bright colors. Okay, is that everything? Feels like everything in the box. Okay. Got a Lite Brite manual. Right off the bat, this is a lot smaller than the original Lite Brite. My original Lite Brite, it was about yay sized, I'd say. It was about so big. Significantly larger than this. And they give you the blanks. Uh-huh. But yeah, this is much smaller than the original Lite Brite. It's like at least 20% smaller overall. But yeah, they give you the kind of the paint by numbers scheme, you know, where they show you where to put the pegs. That's, you know, goes along with the original Lite Brite. There's the sailing ship. Yep. Yada yada. So do they have one in here for Fran Lab, the Fran Lab logo? I don't know. I'm not seeing one for the Fran Lab logo. Well, we'll have to fix that. Template art guide, how to install the batteries. Okay, that's pretty much it. Yeah, it's probably like not legible at all. Made in China. It's got a kickstand. It's really hard to shoot something that's totally white on video. It's not really what video is made to shoot. Yeah, so inside, it's impossible to photograph this completely white thing, but it's just a reflector with a couple of LEDs posted in there, and it's got like a couple on the outside there. Like there's one, two, three, four. It's like there's a spot here for one on the side, but it's not there. And it's like they eliminated two. There's one here, one there. There's two LEDs that they don't even have filled, and two there. It's just a big cardboard reflector. I can't imagine that this is going to look very good. I don't know. I thought it'd be like, I don't know. Well, let's see. So. Oh, the big button that has, oh, it even has a flashing thing. Okay, now I've got dots in my vision, because that's off, on, blinky blinky, super blinky, and random blinky. I'm just going to bypass the whole battery thing and just put an adapter on it right away. And I think I've got one here that would be ideal for that. So I got this 3-volt adapter, which usually they overshoot these, so I think this should be more than fine for this sign. So. So here we go, fire to the wire, and push the button. Yeah. Never trust marked wires. Yeah, got the zilch here. This should be the easy part. I guess, does Walmart really not work? It really seriously does not work. You're freaking kidding me. Alright. No, it's just zero. Okay, well. I guess that proves that my the adapter's no good. I guess, always check parts you pull out of your bin. It might be defective. Alright, well. That is one bad wall wart going in the trash. Here's another one. This is a 9-volt adapter, but I'm just gonna, you know, drop in a. Let's see. And there's the little board with a switch on it. There we go. There's our micro. And of course it's totally potted over, so yeah, we got control transistors or FETs. Well, they're labeled Q, so little bank of transistors there. Yeah, I wonder what the voltage operational range of this thing is. It's kind of hard to say if it's got any kind of like, it's definitely no voltage regulation on there. I have to assume it's 5 volts. This is why I hate non-lead solder, because I just tried to bend that lead and the solder just shattered. It's so soft. The copper is so thin on that board that it has actually lifted up the pad with just that much force. It must be atoms thick of copper. Oh, you fuck. Making more surface area, I scraped away the solder mask, and so I could lay down two big blobs to mount my voltage regulator. See, it's hard to actually do this kind of work and get my brain into the work and actually stay on top of the camera work at the same time, because hands are going all over the place. The exposure is going all over the place. The lighting is all over the place. It's just trying to document this. Okay, so there you go. And that's my voltage regulator. It's an LM317, and I've, you know, put the I made up a 460 ohm resistor out of a 470 and a 1.5K in parallel, and a 1K for the adjustment, which should. It should give me like 4.5, 4.6 volts or something like that. In fact, I'm gonna hook up the voltmeter just to make sure that I've gotten in the ballpark. Here we go. 4.7 volts. Perfect. All right. There we go. That wasn't so hard, was it? Yeah, the microcontroller, you know, it takes power all the time, but micro power, so you can't use just a simple loading resistor because it's not a constant load. The load is shifting from almost zero load when it's off to full load. So, you know, because the microcontroller has to have like less than 5 volts, like 4.5 volts, if you can't just have the without the load on it, the DC voltage goes up to like 9, 10, 10.5 volts on idle, which would just probably cook the microcontroller because it doesn't seem to be any voltage regulator on the board. But there is a 317 works. Yeah, I got the value switched. In my chart, I got the resistor values flipped from what was on the chart because it's kind of arbitrary, the R1, R2, but I just assumed. And when you assume, you make an ass out of you and me, and that's what I did. I assumed and I got it backwards, so anyway. It works. Values are right. 4.5 volts, target voltage. But yeah, I was able to get that in there and tuck that over, so should be fine. I gotta relabel this Fran Brite since it's been totally customized. Okay. We'll be right back.
Hello.
Like 4-year-old Fran would do it. Fran Lab, there you go. All right. Thanks for watching. Thanks to everybody down there on the Patreon. Wouldn't be able to make any of these videos without you. Thank you to everybody on the Patreon. If you like my videos, if you want to help out the Fran Lab, just follow the link in the description and I will thank you personally. All right, that's it for this one. I'm 4-year-old Fran. Bye.
In the lab. That's where I work. In the lab. Go berserk. In my lab. Where I work. What you're watching. Fran Lab. It's what I'm doing. Working at the bench.